Have you ever noticed the sediments on the bottom of a beer bottle? The sediments are yeast particles that settle down over time. You can watch the same effect in a tank filled with wastewater. As in the beer, the particles in the wastewater have a certain gravity force towards the tank bottom. But at the same time, we have drag forces that impact the settling process of the particles. Drag forces can be turbulences, other particles, or sludge accumulation. Sedimentation can only take place if the gravity force of the particle is higher than all drag forces. If the particles settle down, we can define settling distance h divided by time t equals settling velocity vs of the particle. Another important point for the consideration are the particle shapes and sizes. Examples are round, flat, or pointed. The differences lead to different sedimentation velocities. To show the sedimentation pattern, it can be written down in a diagram with time t in horizontal direction over the sedimentation in percent. A practical test to determine the sedimentation pattern and the size of a sedimentation tank is the Imhof Cone experiment. The Imhof cone is filled with wastewater and after certain time steps the sludge accumulation is measured. Again, for further analysis the results can be written down in a diagram. In case you want to do the experiment by your own, you can find the needed equipment in the link below. An effective way to increase the settling performance of the particles significantly is flocculation and coagulation. Let's have a look again at a tank filled with wastewater. If, over a long time period, no sedimentation can be seen, the particles in the wastewater are too small for settling. Under the microscope, you will discover that there are organic and inorganic particles in the wastewater. Organic particles can be bacteria, inorganic particles can be, for example, clay or mineral oxides. The sum of organic and inorganic particles that stay suspended in the wastewater are called colloids. The brownish cloudiness in the wastewater is called turbidity. By adding coagulants such as alum or ferrix, you will see that the brownish turns into clear wastewater and that the sludge accumulates at the tank bottom. So let's have a look how coagulation works in detail. Almost all colloids have a negatively charged double layer. Therefore, two colloids create a responsive force, which prevents them from sticking together. You can see the same effect when you try to hold together two magnets with the same poles. The magnets will repel each other. By adding alum or ferrix to the water, you neutralize the negative charged layer. Adding flocculants and stirring the water carefully will now allow the colloids to stick together. The formed flocs are now heavy enough to settle down. Very similar works precipitation in industrial wastewaters. This water tank with industrial wastewater looks completely clear. However, this tank contains toxic ionic metals that are dissolved in the water. The ionic metals are positively charged. Therefore, if we add negatively charged precipitates, the ionic metals will stick to it. The precipitates, such as calcium hydroxide, are unsolvable so that the ionic metals can now be removed with sedimentation. Liquids with a high content of ionic metals have a pH value below 7. Adding hydroxides will change the pH value above 7 and makes the solution basic. If you wish more information or need support with the design of your water or wastewater project, you can click the link below to contact us.